Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad, Rasulullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Malik yawmiddin. All praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the world, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the compassionate, the most merciful, Malik yawmiddin, the owner of the great day of judgment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his peace and blessings upon his last prophet and messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his companions and upon those who choose to follow the prophetic guidance until the day of judgment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all from among them. My dear brothers and sisters, we're still reflecting upon some of the words of wisdom from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose words were described as al-hikmah, the words of wisdom in the Holy Quran, and whose words were also described as a revelation in the Holy Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He does not speak out of his own whim or desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Rather, it is a revelation revealed. In one of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of these beautiful words that are full of wisdom from the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, he says, هَذِهِ الصَّلَوَاتِ, that these five daily prayers, مَنْ حَافَظَ عَلَيْهِنْ, whoever guards them, whoever takes good care of them, whoever performs them, كَانَتْ لَهُ نُورًا وَبُرْهَانًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, it will be like a light and an evidence for that person on the day of judgment. وَمَنْ لَمْ يُحَافِظَ عَلَيْهِنْ, and if you do not really preserve them, if you do not take good care of them, لَمْ تَكُنْ لَهُ نُورًا, it will not become a light for you, and it will not become an evidence for you on the day of judgment. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَحُشِرَ, and that person who did not preserve his prayers, he did not perform his prayers, وَحُشِرَ, he will be gathered on the day of judgment with Fir'aun, Pharaoh, and Haman, and Ubay ibn Khalaf. These are three wicked disbelievers, people who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, let me start reflecting on this hadith by sharing with you one of the stories of one of my friends who was with me in college. I asked him, why did you start practicing Islam? And he told me I had actually an amazing story. He said, I started practicing Islam because of a dream that I had. So I obviously inquired and asked him, what was that dream? It must be something very interesting. He said, I had a dream that I was sitting in some kind of a conveyor belt, you know, like the ones that you see in the airport, you know, put the luggage in it and so forth. So he said it was moving, and I was sitting on it like that. And in front of me, there were people, and behind me, there were people. So he said, I asked the person in front of me, who are you? He said, I am Fir'aun. And he said, I looked at the person behind me and I asked, who are you? He said, I am Haman. He said, and I was sitting in the middle between these two people. And he said that conveyor belt was moving towards the hellfire, and it keeps dropping people into the hellfire. So he said, I woke up from that dream, and he realized that, alhamdulillah, he was still alive. He did not die. That was not real. It was just a dream. But it was a reminder. It was an alarm that woke him up from deep sleep. He woke up to realize the importance of prayers. So I mentioned to that friend this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said that these prayers, whoever preserves them, takes good care of them, they will become like a light and an evidence for him on the day of judgment. And if you do not preserve them, if you do not take good care of them, they will not become like a light, nor would they become an evidence for you. And on the day of judgment, you'll be gathered with Fir'aun and Haman and Ubay ibn Khalaf. My dear brothers and sisters, the issue of prayers, the issue of performing the namaz, as you call it, the five daily prayers, is an incredibly important issue. The salah is really what differentiates a good Muslim, a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the last day, from a person who's a non-Muslim. By the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahumus salah. Faman tarakaha faqad kafar. Whoever leaves it, meaning these five daily prayers, is no longer a Muslim. One of the things that we want to remember as believers is that if we claim that we really believe in Allah, that means that we also believe that we need to have some sort of a relationship with Allah. It doesn't make sense that to say, yes, I believe in Allah. I believe that Allah exists. I believe that He's the most powerful. I believe that Allah could do whatever He wants to do. I believe that I should put my trust in Allah. I believe that all the provision, all that is, that life and death, everything is in the hands of Allah, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. But then I do not want to have a relationship with Allah. This doesn't make any sense. When you have the door open to have a relationship with the Creator of the heavens and the earth, why would you choose not to come and have a good relationship with Him? This relationship is known in Arabic as salah. Salah comes from the word sila, and sila means a relationship. So every person who believes in Allah should want to have some sort of a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, actually should strive to have a strong relationship with Allah azza wa jal. My dear brothers and sisters, the prophets of Allah, the noble people, needed that relationship. And they were described in different parts of the Holy Quran as people who prayed. For example, if we look at Mary, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's peace and blessings be upon her, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands her, usjudi, prostrate, warka'i ma'arraka'in, and bow with those people who bow. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him in the Holy Quran, usjud, waqtarib, prostrate, make sujood, and come closer. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ, that you will be in the closest position to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are in the position of sujood. When you put your forehead for Allah azza wa jal in the ground and you prostrate to Him and you ask Him for your needs, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ, that you will be in the closest position to Allah when you are in the position of sujood, فَادْعُوا اللَّهِ, so ask Allah, فَقَمِنٌ أَنْ يُسْتِجَابَ لَكُمْ, probably your prayers will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These five daily prayers are so important for us. Why? Because we want to have the peace of mind. Because we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve us from any kind of stress or any kind of worry. And believe me, if you do not pray, you will never achieve this peace of mind. Never, ever could it be achieved for a person who does not pray. I swear by Allah Azza wa Jal that the people who do not pray, they are not the happiest people in this world. Rather, they are living a miserable life. Because Allah clearly tells us, مَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Allah tells us in His book in the Quran that whoever turns away from my remembrance, that he will have a miserable life. And the most important or the most effective way to do this dhikr of Allah, to remember Allah and to mention Allah, is through these five daily prayers, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. That the mentioning, remembering Allah, that happens during the prayer is the greatest. It's the greatest thing that happens, meaning in that salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he's faced with a difficulty, you know what he used to do? He'll make wudu and rush to prayer. As it was described in the hadith, كان إذا حزبه أمر فزع إلى الصلاة. Whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was faced with some kind of a difficulty, he will rush to prayer and try it. We all face difficulties in this life. We all face hard times and so forth. So next time you face some kind of a test or so, go make wudu and pray and ask Allah Azza wa Jal and see how much Allah Azza wa Jal will bestow upon you from His blessings and from His mercy because of that two rak'ahs that you prayed to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was said that one time, one of the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who used to guard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come next to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tried to accompany the Prophet alayhi wa sallam, and he was a young man. So one time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks him, what do you need? Do you need anything? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always asked people for, you know, try to help them and so forth. So he asked him, what do you need? Do you need anything from me? What was that companion's answer? He needed something that was really big. He said, أَسْأَلُكَ مُرَافَقَتَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. He said, O Prophet of Allah, I want to be with you in paradise. I want to be with you in paradise. So the Prophet ﷺ tells him, أَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. Help me by you performing much prostration, much sujood. So we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to help us become from those people who prostrate to Allah, those who make sujood to Allah Azza wa Jal, those who are not arrogant to put their heads in the floor for the Lord and ask Him and come closer and closer to Him. We'll take a short break and inshallah ta'ala, we'll be back. Until then, I leave you with the peace and blessings of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam.
Let me remind you that the glorious Quran is not a book of science, science, but it is a book of signs, signs. It's a book of ayats.
How much time do you spend reading your Quran every day? How much time do you spend in salah?
If you want to be the best, you carry out the work of da'wah, you become the best.
Allah does not count the number of times you repent. Allah looks at the quality of your tawbah and not the quantity of your tawbah.
If you are able to seek knowledge and you choose not to, you carry the full sin.
Islam came to establish a civil society.
This material world is nothing but a test.
This Quran is a miracle of miracles. It's a miracle of all times.
Islam in Focus, every Friday to Wednesday at 11:30 p.m. Saudi Arabia and 12:30 a.m. UAE on Peace TV. He faces.
My question is about.
He listens.
My question is about the beard about Imam Mahdi.
What are the people believe in?
He answers.
So number one is the help of Allah.
He satisfies in the light of glorious Quran and authentic hadith.
If Allah helps you, believe me, you have to get success.
Catch Dr. Zakir.
Then we have the next call, please.
To get convincing and valid answers in Dial Dr. Zakir every Sunday at 7 p.m. Saudi Arabia and 8 p.m. UAE on Peace TV. Islamic International School presents
The purpose of creation is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Precious presenters.
The moral excellence is one of the major objects of Islam.
Promising brews.
It is the belief in Allah.
The Quran is the greatest miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
If you are neglecting to answer for the people, then you are becoming immoral.
An arrogant person will never enter the Jannah.
Death is not the final destination.
Budding role models.
Ek Abraham dutya naste. Bhagwan ek hi hai. Dursa nahi hai. Nahi hai, nahi hai, sala bhi nahi hai.
watch Dais of Islamic International School in Trendsetters, next on Peace TV.
Blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, and welcome back. We're reflecting on the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, alayhi salatu wa salam, هذه الصلوات من حافظ عليهن كانت له نورا وبرهانا يوم القيامة. That these five daily prayers, whoever preserves them, take good care of them, they'll become like a light and an evidence for that person on the Day of Judgment. ومن لم يحافظ عليهن, and if you do not preserve them and take very good care of them, they will not become like a light for you, nor would they become an evidence for you on the Day of Judgment, and the person will be gathered with Fir'aun and Haman and Ubay ibn Khalaf, these three wicked disbelievers. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not only order us in this hadith to pray, but he ordered us to hafaz alayhin, meaning that you preserve these daily prayers, that you take very good care of them, that they become like a priority for you in your life. Many times, my dear brothers and sisters, we find that if we are busy with our work schedules, right, if we're busy running after our dunya and so forth, many of us might delay their prayers. As a matter of fact, they might drop them and do not pray them. And some people, ironically, might gather all of them for Isha time. They pray all five their prayers and they go to sleep. And this is definitely not muhafaza. This is not really a preservation of these prayers. This is not taking good care of these prayers. My dear brothers and sisters, let me take you to a scene that happened, something happened during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I really want your thoughts about this issue. Think about it and answer yourself, please. If your beloved parent, one of them, he's about to die, he's on his deathbed, and they tell you, I just have one little wish that I want you to fulfill for me. I have one little advice, one last request from you, son, that I want you to do. Would you say to them yes or no? If you loved them, then you will say yes. And I'm sure that you will do your best to do whatever they ask you to do. So let us look at this scene in the life of the Prophet ﷺ. It's the last minutes, perhaps, in the life of your most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's about to die and he's leaving this world and he's giving you words of advice. Yes, you, the believer, he's saying, As-salah, 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 the prayer, the prayer, the prayer. He kept saying it alayhi salatu wasalam until his words alayhi salatu wasalam were mixed with this, you know, breathing. You could sometimes hear him and sometimes you cannot hear him. But it is so important that he kept saying it over and over and over. So let us ask ourselves, what did we do to this advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Did we carry it? Did we care for it? Did we neglect it? If we did, it would really be a shame upon all of us. If we did our best to keep this advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to implement it, then inshallah ta'ala we're going to be successful. Many of us are becoming like the person who was described by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as Abdul Dinar, that there is a type of people who are described as the slave of the dinar, meaning, as they say, the slave of the dollar, right? He's imprisoned by this dollar. He's imprisoned by money. He's following money to the point that he's becoming like a slave of it, like he's worshiping it. And that is why he's forgetting about Allah and his messenger and everything that brings him closer to Allah. And most importantly, the five daily prayers. If your job is holding you from your prayers, then there is no good in it. If your job is more important for you than your prayers, then you are a slave of a job and you are not a slave of your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many people say we don't pray because we're lazy. and we ask ourselves a question. If we had a chance to meet with the most important and richest person in this world, and we'll ask him for whatever we need, and surely he's generous and he will give it to us, would we go and meet him and sit with him and talk to him and ask him for our needs? Or would we say, oh no, I'm too lazy, I don't want to go? I bet everyone will be running towards that person. Why? Because they know for sure that if they meet him, he will give them what they need. So what about Allah? What about Allah? What about the real king? What about the owner of this universe? The caller is calling. Hayya ala salah, come to prayer. Hayya ala salah, come to prayer. Hayya ala al-falah, come to success. Hayya ala al-falah, come to the success. Allah is calling you to his house. He wants you in his house. And what a shame. Many times, we reject the invitation. Not an invitation of a rich person, of a generous person, an invitation of Allah Almighty. And we're saying by our actions, no, we don't want to come to your house. We don't need your house. Why? Many people do not pray because they do not realize the kind of sin that they're falling into by not praying. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that the difference between the believer and the disbeliever is this prayer. It's prayer. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, the salah is one of the most beautiful means to purify you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the similitude or the example of the five daily prayers is just like a nahr. It's just like a river in front of your house. And you take a bath in that river five times a day. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, هَلْ يَبْقَى مِنْ دَرَنِهِ شَيْءٍ. Would there remain any kind of filth in you if you take a shower in that river five times a day? He said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no. No filth will remain on us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this is the example of these five daily prayers. These five prayers are the most important thing in your life. After you testify that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah, you know that now the most important mission for you is to perform the five daily prayers, and everything else is not a priority when it comes to salah. You do the salah. When the Muslims were fighting in the battlefield, Allah did not say, okay, don't pray. No, he ordered them to pray and he showed them how to pray in a battlefield. If a person is sick, he can't pray standing, he's not excused. Pray sitting. He can't pray sitting, lay on your side and pray. Is there any excuse for me not to pray at all? No, you have to pray. Unless it's a woman and she's in her menses, she doesn't have to pray until she's cleared. These five daily prayers, this is the most important thing for you. So pay attention to it. Why? Because on the day of judgment, guess what's the first question that you're going to be asked about? Is it how much money do you make? Is it how people thought of you, like you were a very nice and kind person and so forth, what a sweet person? Is it how much wealth you collected? Did you have a house or you didn't have a house? All of these things are beautiful and important, but the most important question is your prayer. The first question on the day of judgment is about salah, about namaz, the five daily prayers. If you performed them and you did well, then the Prophet ﷺ promised you, كَانَتْ لَهُ نُورًا وَبُرْهَانًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. It will become like a light and an evidence for you on the day of judgment. But if you did not take good care of them, لَمْ تَكُنْ لَهُ نُورًا وَلَا بُرْهَانًا. It will not be like a light or an evidence for you on the day of judgment. And you will fail that exam. And what a horrible failure. Because the punishment is a blazing fire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all from the hellfire. My dear brothers and sisters, if you want to start praying, I'll give you one tip that I want you to keep in mind, and I'm going to conclude with it, inshallah. If you find it difficult for you to start praying the five daily prayers, or to maintain the 5 daily prayers, I want to give you one tip. I want you to realize and to understand deeply from your heart that you will not be able to do it unless Allah helps you to do it. So turn to Him and ask Him, and He will inshallah grant you that. One of the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ was sitting after the Salah. One of the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ was sitting after the Salah, and the Prophet ﷺ turns to him. He says to him, "Oh Mu'adh," his name was Mu'adh, "I love you for the sake of Allah. So do not forget to say about each after each Salah, Oh Allah, Allahumma a'inni. Oh Allah, help me. Ala dhikrik," remembering and mentioning you. "Wa shukrik," being thankful to you. "Wa husni ibadatik," and to worship you in the best of fashions. My dear brothers and sisters, every one of us knows the word Iyyaka na'bud. You alone do we worship. Wa iyyaka nasta'in. And you alone do we seek His help. So when we seek Allah's help, the most important thing is to seek Allah's help to help us do the ibadah, do the worship. Again, my tip to all of you is turn to Allah and ask Allah to help you pray. And if you're sincere, Allah will guide your steps. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us maintain these 5 daily prayers. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make these prayers a comfort for our eyes, just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. We'll continue inshallah with our talks in the near future inshallah with coming episodes. And until then, I leave you with the peace and the blessings of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
Thank you Allah for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad, Rasulullah. Everything in creation praises you.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessings upon His last Prophet and Messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His companions, and upon those who choose to follow the prophetic guidance until the day of judgment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all from among them. My dear brothers and sisters, we're still reflecting upon some of the words of wisdom from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whose words were described as al-hikmah, the words of wisdom in the Holy Quran, and whose words were also
Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad, Rasulullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawmiddin. All praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the worlds, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the compassionate, the most merciful, Malik Yawmiddin, the owner of the great day of judgment. And we ask Allah, described as a revelation in the Holy Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He does not speak out of his own whim or desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Rather, it is a revelation revealed. In one of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in one of these beautiful words that are full of wisdom from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, هَذِهِ الصَّلَوَاتِ, that these 5 daily prayers, مَنْ حَافَظَ عَلَيْهِنْ, whoever guards them, whoever takes good care of them, whoever performs them, كانت له نورا وبرهانا يوم القيامة. It will be like a light and an evidence for that person on the day of judgment. ومن لم يحافظ عليهن. And if you do not really preserve them, if you do not take good care of them, لم تكن له نورا. It will not become a light for you. And it will not